Today we're going to be decommissioning my Amazon Echo Connect. I don't want to decommission it, but there's no sense in it being here because they dropped support for the fucking thing. So we got to take it down and get it out of there. We'll get into the semantics of why and how this was decommissioned by them afterwards. But meanwhile, let me see if I can get up here and get this disconnected without killing myself, which would only just be a little bit of a plus. So here it is. All the lights are on solid. It's exactly as it should be. There are links in the prescription back to January of 2022 when I first deployed this, and it has been the best thing since sliced bread. Yep, that's right. This is it.
The greatest thing since sliced bread. So this is it, huh, folks?
It's great. I have 10 Echo devices around the house, and when the home phone would ring, this would get that info from the phone line and convert that and send it out to all the devices, and all around the house, it would tell me who's calling. And now, Amazon took that away, so it's sitting here simply using electricity and not doing anything. So we're gonna get rid of it because it serves no purpose now. So let me get up in here. I think this is the power for it. It is kind of precariously sitting, so that's part of it. Come on. It's almost out of the electrical socket. Oh, it's just not wanting to go. There it goes. That's out. That won't stay. That's good. Let me see if I can get the little, this guy, out of there. It's a back pocket find right there. Can I get the cords? Well, not exactly, and I'm going to wait to disconnect the other one first. That is tricky because of where I have this here. I have to reach in without killing myself and disconnect it and run the wire back through. Up here, hopefully not breaking a little tab off the guy. Okay, it's through there. Now it's stuck. That's good. I don't know what it's stuck on. No, that's that one. There it is. Stuck on itself. And another wire there. Okay, with any luck, this should sort of just peel away. Let me see if I get this cord here. It's got to go through that. Let's see what other fuck goofery we're up against here. That's lovely. Almost there. One other wire. Come on, man. And then this has to go through. It's out. Straighten everything up. Let me see if I can put that down a second. It's not perfect, but I think that'll do right there. See if I get this back sitting good. That's all good. Okay, it's officially out of service. You know, there's a lot of dust on top of the pipes up here. So here she be. Nothing wrong with it. Almost no dust on the fucking thing to speak of. This can disconnect. This can disconnect. And now we got this guy that's stuck on there. Probably forever. So I think I'll just leave it on there. And I'll cut the cable tie off. And then the cords will go back in their respective boxes of shit. Because they don't need to be with a device that is not working and can always be gotten out of said boxes at a later date. So we'll undo that. Easier said than done. There we go. And this guy we'll undo. It's barely warm. So there's all that, and I gotta get I got these little guys at little. That's kind of why they're small. And I'm just gonna leave that on there. Probably because the adhesive is spent on it. Yep. All the hell I went through just to get this thing installed. And then they yanked fucking support. Why would they do that? Well, I will tell you this much. I had bought this thing basically almost for a song. It was 20 or 30 bucks. We'll say 20 bucks, I think more was what it was. Because Amazon was discontinuing the device. But there was no indication that they were discontinuing the service that runs the device. And everything went happily for 2 years until I think it was February of this year, where they just, you know, didn't really even tell anybody. There was just kind of a message somewhere that you would have to happen to come across and that they were discontinuing service on it. I understand that not many people these days have a home phone anymore, and the Amazon Echo can still make calls when linked to a cell phone, kind of over its own service. In other words, if you're talking through it to somebody, whatever number you dial, it's not using your cell phone. You can still use your phone to dial out to another party if you wanted. So there's that. I don't know. It's just an odd thing. And like I was saying, I get that not a lot of people have home phone service, but still there were. Now, did they discontinue service on this because there was still a dwindling number of people using it and they didn't want to invest support into it? Well, Amazon is a multi-billion dollar company. So I can't understand why paying an employee even $100 an hour to fix this if the software goes wonky for 10 hours, $1,000 out of a multi-billion dollar company, what is that? It's fucking chump change. And they no longer support it. The software was written and working. Now, it was not fun setting this guy up. Why it was so cumbersome, I don't know. I went through a lot of hell. Again, the links to doing that are in the prescription. Why it was so convoluted as far as that goes, I don't know. But I did get it working, of course, and it was great. We really enjoyed this thing because all over the house, it would just tell me who's calling. Now I don't have that function anymore. I don't pay any less for Amazon Prime. There's no additional fee you can pay to keep service on this device, and it's a damn good thing they didn't charge for that either. But the software was written, was stable, and it was working. And they took it away. I'd like to know, if anybody has any idea why they would do that, leave a comment. But I'm going to tell you about a couple other things that Amazon pulled back in the day. The Whiff has an Amazon Kindle keyboard. She, in fact, did a video on that, which is in the prescription. You could watch that. And she showed you all the features and the functions. And it was an early e-ink ebook reader. And it had a keyboard on it. And you could send emails with it if you wanted to. And the e-ink display was well suited for just text like that. It was fine. And the model that she had had 3G wireless support as well as Wi-Fi. Well, a couple things happened with that. First of all, some people learned how to hack the device and have it tether the 3G, which was free, included just for buying it, tether the 3G to the Wi-Fi that then they could use for other stuff. Now, granted, yes, it was only 3G speed. That was taken away, but that wasn't Amazon's fault. It's because 3G has been shut down. So that's kind of fair game, and I get that. And if you own one, which we do, it sucks. But again, you know, everybody's within Wi-Fi signal a lot of times. And where are you going to be reading it? At the park? Oh, let me look for a new book at the park? No, it doesn't work that way. You say, I have The Catcher in the Rye, and I'm on page 136, and it's such a nice day, I'd love to go sit at the park and continue reading that book that I already have on the fucking device. It still works over Wi-Fi. It's still fully functional. You can still get books, read books, all that kind of stuff. Take books out from your local library. Ebooks. It's all still there. Unless they pulled that also. I remember the Whiff saying something about that. I can't remember exactly what. But it also had two other features. One was the ability to play music. It was built right in the device. And you could hook it up to the computer with the included USB cable and put MP3s on it. It also had a headphone jack, so you could do private listening, and it would also function as an MP3 player. You don't need that, because of course your fucking phone does that, but still, it might be nice. Maybe you had peaceful music you like to listen to while reading, while sitting in the park, and this way you don't have to pester with your phone, which might ring, which, of course, it could do anyway while you're playing music. But, you know, it's one less device that you have to bring with you, carry with you, and deal with that's on your person. And, you know, be stolen when it's in your handbag sitting on the bench next to you. It's one less thing to worry about. So it was built in. Now, they didn't pull that function because it's hard-coded in the firmware of it. The other thing that it had was text-to-speech, which means it could read the book aloud to you. All of the newer Kindles... Oh, and I'm sorry, it also had a web browser built in. It did say it was experimental, and I get that, and it was clunky at best, and it was slow. The processor in it really isn't fast because it's a fucking ebook reader. What does it really need? So I get that part of it, but it had a web browser built in, it had MP3 functionality built in, and text-to-speech. Well, the newer Kindles don't have any of that. The web browser, okay, it doesn't work well with an e-ink display, so I could see that. Why did they pull MP3 support? Don't know. How about text-to-speech? Well, there's a damn good reason for that, and that's because Amazon bought Audible. And now you have to sign up for that service and pay for it. So, once again, money talks, bullshit walks. This country operates on money and money alone. But why pull something that has software set up, is running, requires almost no processing power on their end, nothing, you know, there was no maintenance whatsoever. It needed absolutely nothing. And they yanked service on it. Let me know why you think that is in the comments below. It's definitely a sad end. We've missed this thing for a couple of months. It's April now, and I just got around to taking it down now. Definitely not cool, Amazon. So let me know what you think in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Make sure you click like, make sure you click subscribe, and take care. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.